Hey guys, it's Shannon. Today we're going to be making a bed service tray with the help of some supplies from the Dollar Tree. All right, to get started, let me give you a look at all the supplies I'll be using to create this project. Like I said, you're going to need a couple things from the Dollar Tree, and they are going to be the legs to this tray. I have two rolling pins here that I'm going to cut in half, and then I'm also going to be using a 1x12 cut down for the top. Then I'm also going to be using a brad nailer, some wood glue, and some wood stain, and a few other things like my tape measure and a pencil to measure everything out. And I'll make sure to include all of the measurements as I go along, and also some suggestions to alternate items if you don't have these bigger power tools, what you can use instead. You want to start by cutting your rolling pins in half. Each rolling pin is 12 inches long, so once you cut them in half, they will be 6 inches long. I'm using my miter saw here, but you can also use a hand saw for this. Next, I cut down a 1x12 to 20 inches long for the top, and you can also ask the home improvement store where you purchase your wood from to cut your wood down for you as well. Then it was time to sand all the pieces down. I used 80 grit sandpaper for this. And I also made sure to sand down the rolling pins just a little bit. They're pretty much smooth and sanded already for you, but once they're cut, they have some raw edges, so you want to make sure you round those off. These rolling pins actually make the perfect little feet for this tray. As you can see, one end is tapered. So I used the broader end for attaching to the tray top, and then the tapered end was more of the bottom where the feet are. Next, I attached each foot with some wood glue to the corners, and I didn't put them exactly butted up into the corner. I kind of offset them a little bit so they wouldn't be too close to the corner, and that would give a little bit more sturdiness to the tray once it was put together. Once all 4 feet were attached with wood glue, I let the tray sit for a few minutes to let the glue dry before I flipped the tray over. Next, I took my brad nailer and 1¼-inch brad nails and added 3 nails to each corner into those feet to make sure they were nice and sturdy and secure. If you don't have a brad nailer, of course you can use just a plain hammer and nails for this as well. Next, I decided to stain my piece. Of course, you could always paint this and make it match your room's decor. I'm using the wood stain by Minwax called Duck Bean. This is the one I use in my house for pretty much everything. I love it. It's a dark wood stain and you can get away with one coat on this. However, if you really want a super dark look, you could do 2 coats, and that's beautiful as well. If you aren't already, you can also find me on social media, both Instagram and Facebook, and follow me over there. I will have those both linked down in the description box below. Then I let this piece completely dry and cure overnight before going back to seal it. I used this polycrylic in a clear matte finish to use as a protective layer. I didn't want this sitting in our bed or sitting on a furniture piece and potentially having any of the wood stain rub off, so I did want to make sure I sealed this piece. I'm using a paintbrush from the Dollar Tree to apply this. I love their paintbrushes. They work great for stuff like this. And the great thing about polycrylic is that it dries really quickly too. So you can get 2 coats on and let it dry and it's ready to go in about an hour. We've been working really hard on our new bedroom, trying to create a relaxing and calming retreat for us. And we also recently removed the TV from our bedroom. And I'm curious to know how many of you also go without a TV in your bedroom. Let me know down in the comments below. Here's a look at the tray, completely finished and styled on our new bed in our new bedroom. If you'd like to see the video that gives you a before and after of our modern bedroom update, I will have that video linked down in the description box below. This tray is the perfect size for breakfast in bed. I also made sure that it was big enough to fit my laptop on so I can do some editing while I'm in bed. And of course, you could create this to fit your size and your needs. I hope that this video inspired you. Make sure to give it a thumbs up for me. You can share this with your friends and family and inspire them as well. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I do DIY tutorials every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And I want to thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.